Hello and welcome everyone to another NASCAR Racing 2003 live stream. How is everyone doing today? Thank you very much for joining. Pulling up my preview on my laptop here. How is everyone doing? Thank you very much for joining in for this video today. Is my microphone working this time? I believe it is. Alright, thank you guys so much for joining in. As you can see by the title of today's stream, I have a very, very special video today. I'm going to be attempting to recreate the biggest crash in the history of NASCAR. And right off the bat, I just want to thank JeBrown, however that's pronounced, over on stunoddracing.com. Link is down in the description. As well as, he, as well as many others over on StunOdd, put together this amazing 1956/55 car set I will be using for this video for the Grand National 55 mod, for whom I also want to thank DesModsRacing, which I know is no longer operational, kind of got turned into StunOdd Racing. But without DMR, I believe, they were the ones that created the GN 55 mod in the first place. So without all of those guys, this video wouldn't be possible. So thank you very much. That being said, as most of you may know that follow the sport, you've probably seen this video before. The largest crash in the history of NASCAR back in the 1960 Modified Sportsman's Race, a few days before the 500. Wasn't actually the 500, that's a big misconception. Thank you to Jacob Hernandez for the capture, and let's watch what happens.
68 cars leave the pit and move smoothly into the first turn behind the pace car. Bill France, president of NASCAR, the National Association for Stock Cars, leads them around.
And obviously due to game restrictions, I'm only going to be able to do 43 cars at once, but I'll try to make do with what I have.
Fireball Roberts and Marion Farr complete the first two rows.
Jesus, 68 cars in one.
Pit road on the next go round,
in one damn race, that's nuts. Whoa. Oh, never mind, I went away. This is 1960. The car set that I have for the GN55 mod is 56, so it's a few years off, but it's obviously the closest thing I will have to trying to recreate this wreck.
They're moving faster now, riding higher on the 31-degree bank turn, designed for speeds of 200 miles an hour. The pace car's off the track. Here they come.
Jesus, there's still so many cars way in the back of the field.
They're racing.
I believe this was on the first lap the wreck happened. Jesus, look at them, 2-3 wide. Nice, awesome added sound effects. You'd think they would have had microphones back then for the actual races.
At 150 miles an hour.
Side by side, still.
Out of the fourth turn, end of lap one. The leader's at record speed, but the rest of the field is in trouble. Back in the fourth turn.
All right, so about 10 cars back is when they all start wrecking. And turn late in turn four. At least a few cars upside down. At least 20 are involved already. 25, 30.
The most fantastic pileup in all,
all right.
Racing
so obviously, since I can't use it. I'll let this guy finish talking. Alright, just showing the aftermath. Alright, so that is the... that's the gist of what I'm going to be trying to do. So obviously, because of game restrictions, since I can only use 43 cars instead of 68, it's going to be slightly smaller scale, but still, hopefully I can... you guys will get the point if I can get a close enough attempt. I want to have at least 25 cars involved and hopefully get at least 3 or 4 to turn over. That's basically my only requirement. I'm going to be using just a random ass car from this these awesome car sets, which I will show you again. 1956, look at all these. Fireball Roberts. Oh yeah, that's who I am. Lee Petty. Look at all these names. Bob Myers. Joe Weatherly. Look at all these names. Billy Myers. Who else do I recognize? Buck Baker. Alright, so let's jump in. So obviously, oh, the face cam is out. Face cam is out. There we go. Knew something was off. Alright, so it was just like that for a few seconds. I switched back to the wrong screen. It wasn't like that the whole time. Alright, I panicked there for a second. Alright, let's turn their speed up. So obviously I tweaked some of the track INI settings, and before I saw the face cam was off, I was saying, since there is no 1955 version of Daytona, I'm just going to have to use one of the 1970s, which you see here. I'm yet to find a version of Daytona where it's just the guardrail for the outer wall. This is the earliest one I could find, the 1970 or the GN1970, the Grand National one down here, which are basically the same thing. I'm just going to be using this one. It's back. Face cam's back. Calm down. Alright, so let's do this. I have the temperature turned down, the chassis type set to 5. I have the grip turned up a little bit, just a little bit. And I have the decel and panic deceleration turned way down for the AI cars. That's what I've tweaked so far. We'll see if I have to make any other adjustments. Thank you guys for everyone that's watching so far. If you guys could please hit the like button. As we're about to get started with hopefully the biggest crash I've ever done for one of these streams. Excuse me. Oh, we got a race on? On NBC? I think they're racing tonight. It's still a decent amount of cars, even though it's only 43. It still looks like a big, full field. Not quite 68, but... So let's get up to the front. Since we can't use as many cars, we're not gonna start the wreck, like, 12 cars back, like in the video. We're gonna do it maybe 6 or 7 cars back. Shoot. It's one downside to turning the grip up. Not the grip up, the track temperature way down. That's what I meant to say. Alright, so we're gonna do it this way the first time, I guess, since I spun out. Maybe this could work. I'll just have to do a little creative editing. No. Come on. I got some of them. That's all that matters. I got some of them. I cannot explain to you how slick the track is when you turn the track temperature down.
The pace cars in turn one. You blew the engine. The pace cars in turn two.
Alright, so let's see a replay of what just happened there. There's not much damage, or there's not any damage at all for this mod except for the tires and the engines. Few cars taking a big ride. Look at the number 64. Alright, so we're going to have to try that again, obviously. Obviously.
Drivers, stop your engines!
Which channel is NBC anyway? Race over. Already? Alright, I'm gonna do a slightly different method of getting up to speed this time that I was doing in practice. That seemed to be working out just fine. And go through the pits. Find the race. Stupid million channels. Alright, I'm just gonna try it this way. There we go. That worked. Sixty-eight cars play follow the leader at 150 miles an hour. God damn it. I didn't mean to get loose there. I wrecked too early. So the engine and the tires are the only thing that can get damaged with this mod. Alright, hopefully I'll get a good attempt this time without crashing prematurely. On his side. Did I hit the pace car or go through the pace car? It's funny, I don't even notice at this point. If I had NASCAR Racing 2003 season, doesn't the pace car like glitch you out when you hit it? It just makes you go flying. This one should go over a lot better. This is one way to get near the front of the pack. Whoa, what happened to the 42? What happened to the 42? Is he gonna steal my thunder? Nope. I'm dropping back quickly. Need to catch up to the front. Yes, I know we're going a little faster than they were in real life. But during my tests, having it at the slower chassis type meant they weren't wrecking big at all. Alright, here we go. Let's try and see what happens here. I think I waited a little too late. Waited a little too late for that one. And I wasn't quite as near the front as I should have been. Alright, I need to do a better method of wrecking next time. That didn't take out too many cars. Maybe I need to start low and turn hard right. Let's try to take out as many rows as possible.
Drivers, stop your engines!
There's only one more thing I need when trying to cause giant wrecks on purpose. Trying to cause as much carnage as possible. You know what that is? I'm off work today. I can drink. Don't judge me. Yeah, thank you for Scamp Dalmatian for bringing it up bluntly. Rest in peace, Fireball Roberts. The paint scheme that I'm using. God damn it. Alright, give me one more time and I'll have a serious attempt, but this time I'm going backwards again. Except this time I'll actually get it.
You've been disqualified for reckless driving.
Yeah, that sucks with Fireball Roberts' crash. From what I read, when flying, hit the pit wall, flipped upside down, and yeah, his car was on fire while he was upside down. See if I get him. Come on. Oh, I missed the entire pack. Missed the entire damn pack. Sorry, guys. This one will get more exciting in a few. Gonna turn traction control on. That'll help. Because I have the lower track temperature just because it makes them accelerate quicker and just makes the cars overall faster. And yeah, if I do the Daytona jump next time with the traction control on, it won't be as much of a fail. Coke Zero blowover. Which one was that? Coke Zero blowover. I know Clint Bowyer flipped in the duels. And Kyle Busch flipped upside down from the banking when he got T-boned. At a slow speed. Don't know of a Coke Zero blowover that's happened in a while. Matt Crafton, I've already tried once, but yeah, I need to do a part two for that one. Austin Dillon's I've already tried three damn times. I'm just gonna do this. There we go. Up to speed, don't spin out. Perfect. Now I can try to cause a big wreck. I'm just gonna be on the bottom line and turn dead right. Whoa. Almost another premature one. Except my traction control is making me a little slower. I'm trying to get up to a high speed. There we go. I'll try this. Come on. Come on, someone flip over.
We got big time problems with that motor, buddy.
Nope.
Your front end's all smashed in.
I think I might need to wait another lap or two to wait for them to be a little more spaced out so they come piling in more instead of being all bunched together and kind of slowing to a big piled heap altogether. So maybe, or adjust the settings to make them a bit more strung out. Yeah, I'll try a couple more times like this, but yeah, I might have to adjust the settings or wait another lap, or both, to have the cars be a bit more spaced out. So yeah, when the wreck starts, the people behind them, or behind the wreck, come piling in. Or yeah, instead of just kind of all bunching together in one massive pileup and skidding to a smoldering heap. $2,000 Cracker Barrel 500. Is that the Ricky Craven, Kurt Busch, Darlington? If so, I'm going to do that the week leading up to the first Darlington race this season. So yes, I will be doing that one. I intend on doing that one. That's the only thing I'm waiting for. By the way, I was going to wait till around 200 if the cars were out by then. Episode 200 for the live stream, that is. To wait to do this one, but I got so excited when the car set came out, I couldn't wait, so I waited till episode 160 because of 1960. So I'm gonna right now. Oh, we got one upside down. Yep. Same thing that time. A lot of them just missed. Or maybe I need to start up high and then turn down low. Alright, so at least we had one turnover in that one. But we need more. We need more pileup and we need more flips. We need more flips! Oh yeah. What was the Cracker Barrel? Or is that the Atlanta finish? With, Bobby Labonte and Dale Earnhardt? 2000 Cracker Barrel? Can't remember off the top of my head. Not enough cars involved. That just means we have to cause another crash. Oh no. How sad, we have to cause more carnage. Brewers spring training. Who the fuck cares? Brewers are gonna be the next Cubs. Earnhardt Labonte at Atlanta. Alright, cool. My second guess was the right one. Let's get up to the front. I guess, yeah, this will involve experimenting a few times with seeing what kind of method of wrecking the AI cars ends up causing the biggest pileup behind. Probably a little bit of practice and a little bit of luck. I see we're dropping a few frames. Just hang in there. It should be over with shortly. Whenever the frames are dropping, it's not more than a few moments. No! Well, no. That was completely accidental. I pushed up the track and got into the car in front of me. And went into orbit.
Drivers, stop your engines!
Yeah, that was completely accidental, for those of you wondering. Pushed up the track, didn't take that turn coming off of too tight enough. Just tapped the car on the outside and that sent me sideways. And I even hit the invisible wall. Man, that looks cool. It looks like the same basic cockpit, but I don't know, I love the in-car views for all the mods. Let's try doing with the in-car view this time. The front as we can and causing mayhem coming out of turn 3 into turn 4. had some good three wide bump drafting action going on with these 1955 cars. 200 miles an hour. Yeah, that's accurate. I think I waited a little too long that time too. I like how it looks like there's damage in the in-car view for this mod, but then you go to the roof cam and there's nothing. It's deceiving. Let's see what that replay looked like. Not a single car flipped over, and once again, I need to do it like going into turn three. Because they were done crashing before they got to the end of the banking coming out of turn four. And every single crash I've had, we've gotten to the exit of turn four before they're done coming to a stop. One of these times I have to get lucky. Alright, so if I can get a good attempt this time, but the crash doesn't look good, the attempt after this one, I'll try waiting two laps around to see if they're a little more spaced out than to see if the cars behind the initial wreck sort of pile in more. Because I have all the acceleration and panic deceleration, turned way down. But I just don't think there's enough space to where they're really crashing in hard to flip over. They're kind of just all bunching up together and drifting to a stop. And since there's no damage for this mod, the cars can drive away a lot easier since they don't really get damaged. The only damage there really is if they take a super hard shot to blow the engine. Whoa. Get an aero loose with a 1955 car. Too much draft. Yes, I know I have to change some settings. Alright, so yeah, we got one flip. Yeah, wrecking and the banking of the turn helps, because the cars then want to come back up in front of. Oops. Sorry, that wasn't your guys' computer messing up. That was a stupid pop-up that popped up. Alright, so this time I'm going to try waiting a lap to see if they space out a little bit more. And if that doesn't work, then I will try tweaking the track INI to see what I can do in there. Try to make the cars a little more spaced out. Maybe turn the draft... Oh, yeah, I'll try turning the drafting distance way up. The drafting and bunching distance way up. AI grass grip, that's another good idea. Turn the AI grass grip up to like 3 or 5, somewhere around there. Alright, so all good ideas. Alright, so drafting distance up, bunching distance up, AI grass grip up, user grass grip, turning that up probably wouldn't hurt. Oops, I was in the wrong gear. Alright, so right where I want to wreck. About 5 or 6 back from the start. The leader is at record speed, but the rest of the field is in trouble, back in the fourth turn. God, I cannot tell you how many times I've seen that video, as a kid and recently, doing the prep for this video. I'm going to try starting up high and then turning down into the cars, which did not work at all. But maybe this will. Alright, one flip. Damn it. Still not big enough of a wreck. Yep, definitely not. How are so many cars sneaking through? I turn their AI. Alright, we're gonna do some track. I know I was gonna wait two laps for this one, but I'm too impatient, so we're gonna do some track. I tweaking. Abandon the race, yes. Going to abandon it. Just leave it out in an alley somewhere. Alright, I know the screen is black for you guys, just give me a second to change this. Boom. Alright, here we are in the NASCAR Racing 2003 season folder. Let's go to tracks. 1970 version 2. Track INI. That's why. Forgot about the stupid CTS physics. Alright, so first off, AI, grass, grip. Turn that to 4. We'll just start low-ish. AI D-cell, let's turn that to 5. So panic D-cell is 0.1, D-cell is 0.5. Save, let's go back up. Why didn't we full screen that? Alright, what else can we do? Alright, AI drafting distance. Bunching distance. I don't know if I have to copy and paste this to down here, but I'm going to anyway. Just to be safe. Down to the CTS physics spot. Alright, bunching distance. Let's turn this up to 2.9. Drafting distance 2.5, sure. Alright, anything else? Alright, I think we can turn the track temperature down just a tad. Negative 38. Still make the cars faster, but not so much to where I'm spinning out every 5 seconds. Okay, so anything else I can think of? Drafting distance, bunching distance, AI grass grip, and AI panic D-cell. Which are all down here. Okay, let's see what that does. Save. Let's load the game back up. Let's see if that does any difference. I'm excited to see what that did. Alright, everything else is the same. Let's go right into the race. I tweak the temperature up a little bit, turn the drafting and bunching distance up, turn the panic D-cell down, and turn the AI grass grip up. Let's see if those turned do anything. Turn the grip up, I might have to try that. Kevin LePage causing the big one. That's a good one. Alright, I'm excited to see if this did anything. Should have turned the pacing distance up, too. more spaced out already. Is that the bunching distance, I'm assuming? Alright, this looks a lot better already. They're gonna be a little faster in this game than they were in real life, but just for the sake of trying to cause the biggest wreck possible. Alright, they're pretty back there. They're pretty spaced out. Hopefully if I cause a wreck big enough and they come back up into the track, they keep piling in. Alright, so let's let those leaders get ahead a little bit. Oh, damn it. I missed. Oh yeah, that definitely helped, those settings. I saw at least three cars rolling over. One went a little far, but those settings definitely helped, having the cars more spaced out. That definitely helped. That was pretty damn close. Chat's frozen, sorry, I'll unfreeze it. I'm definitely saving that one as attempt number one. That was pretty damn close, honestly. One rollover, two rollovers, three rollovers, four. No, three. I unfroze it. Here, I'm going to try something. Just want to do something real quick. Turn the volume down on this. Load that replay back up. Alright, here's what I was gonna do. I wanna play the sound at the same time. Alright, here we go.
Out of the fourth turn, end of lap one. The leader's at record speed, but the rest of the field is in trouble back in the fourth turn.
Kind of. Probably off sync a little bit.
The most fantastic pileup in auto racing history takes 37 cars out of the race.
And
some drivers free themselves from the wrecked cars to find out, is anyone hurt?
Hold on, I'll turn that audio off in a second. Alright, next attempt. That was promising. That was pretty damn good. Except now I need to turn this sound back on. There we go. No, not discard. Accept. There we go. And I have tomorrow off too, so if I get a good attempt, I can spend all night and day tomorrow and tonight editing this. I think maybe turning the drafting and bunching distance up really helped. Because the cars are way more spaced out, so they have a lot more momentum to plow into. Probably also the panic deceleration helped too, considering I was turning it down in the wrong area initially. Forgot about the little spot for the CTS physics. cars get ahead a little bit. As close. Ow.
That hurt.
I saw at least one flip, I think, or at least a car on its side, the number 15 up here. Or sorry, 015. Car on its side. Any flips? Oh yeah. Got one flip right there. Me flying towards the infield. Alright, next.
Drivers, start your
next attempt. Alright, this one will be a lot better. I wasn't as close to the front as I wanted to be. Hold on, I'm checking out of the window, so it's going to freeze for a second. Alright, here we go. I don't want to jinx anything. We've only had 200 drop frames, and the stream's been going for 45 minutes. At least drop frames that are recognized on OBS. It looks a little choppy every now and then. Why are you guys talking about potato salad? Did Poland Spring Monster Jam used to be the Voting Globe 1000 whatever? I recognize the profile picture. Unless it's someone that just used the same profile picture. Here we go. Here we go. Trying to cause the ultimate big one. That sounds wrong. That 500 car looks cool. Is there a cooler number than 500 for a race? A lot bigger pileups. Have I seen All Dogs Go to Heaven when I was like... I did. But it was literally probably 20 years ago, so... Can't say I remember a single bit of it. Alright, that was good. That was a good one. Not as many cars flipped over as I wanted to, but the pileup was good. I want to start near the front this time again, but get a little space between myself and the leaders and the rest of the pack. So during the replay, the cars can be up by the closer to the trioval and finish line when the when you see the cars wrecking in the background in turn four. Definitely on to something with the... I think I have the settings right, I just need to try a bunch of times now. Because I've seen a few that look decent, it's just a matter of trial and error at this point. I think I've done all I can for the settings. Thanks to anyone who might be watching this right now that just joined in or has been watching the whole video, thank you so much for watching this. If you are enjoying the video so far, if you don't mind hitting the like button, I'd really appreciate it. As I'm sure Fireball Roberts would as well. Uh-oh. I jokingly spoke about what a dead celebrity may or may not have endorsed or thought positively of. Am I going to get in the same trouble as Justin Bieber did over that Anne Frank comment? If Anne Frank was alive today, she'd be a Belieber. Alright, so now we have space between us and the leaders. Now time to cause the wreck. Cars roll over. I didn't see any rollovers. Alright, we're gonna have to try that again. The video just didn't get all choppy for you guys, did it? Or is it just my laptop that's being screwy? Right here, I just... Right now, it should be paused. And then I just unpaused it. Before I said something, was it choppy or was it just my laptop? While I was saying something, I was checking something outside of the game window. Joey Logano drives a Ford, right? Yes, he does. Just thinking of that today. It'd be awesome to get one of those 2016 Ford Fusions. Those things look badass. I feel it. Let the leaders get there. Get their distance. Look at that, three wide for the lead. These old ass cars. I was having a little better luck when I was starting out low and turning up, so I'll try that again this time.
Drivers, start your engines!
Sorry, that comment wins for that comment wins for today, according to Wikipedia. Oh my god.
Get ready now. Going green. Pit car's in.
He spun me out. I was laughing so hard. Oh. All right. I'm just gonna try to
you've been disqualified to
cause a wreck this way. The old traditional going backwards way. Why is that so goddamn funny? It shouldn't have been that funny, but it is for some reason. Aw, damn it. And hit the car I wanted to.
There's too much debris on the track. The pace cars exiting the tri-oval.
Is it now? Alright, let's see if my next attempt I don't spin out in the pace lap from geeking out. Here we go. What'll happen from this? The original Arca brakes.
Drivers, start your engines!
Yeah, I don't know why I laughed so hard either. It wasn't... I mean, it was funny, but it shouldn't have been that funny. I just saw you guys... talking about whether or not some person who I don't even know who you're talking about is alive or dead. I saw something about Wikipedia saying he was dead. According to Wikipedia, your mom is dead. Oh god, that was such a cookie cutter line, but it was perfectly placed. Your mom lines are usually very hacky and cliche, but I haven't heard that in a while. That one was, I don't know, there's something about how long it's been since I've heard the line like that and the situation it was used in. It was just the perfect blend. It caught me geeking out. I waited a little too long this time too, so I need to cut through the pits. Bye, pace car. Boom. Oh, I pulled a Ward Burton. The number 2 of 22 cat car, I believe that was Ward Burton at the time. When he avoided that wreck, flew through the pits, tried going back and merging with the field at full speed. And caused a wreck. See if I can get everyone involved. Oh, nope, I missed that one car. Damn. There's no shortage of rollovers that time. Except I messed up the initial attempt.
Drivers, start your engines!
Oh god. That was good. Solder car for gas money. Or you could be like Ray from Trailer Park Boys and rip the plumbing out of your walls to sell for scrap for liquor money. I don't know if anyone remembers that wreck I'm talking about at Daytona where the 22 car tried flying through the pits to avoid a wreck and tried merging back with the field right here at full speed, but then caused a small wreck. It caused a big one, I should say, trying to get back merged with the field. Does anyone know what year that was? What year in race? Get off the damn apron, Cody. Stop looking at the comments. And focus on causing carnage. Alright, so I'm gonna start down low and turn up. That seems to be working better than starting down high and turning low. I think I waited a little too long because there was a good group. Need to do it like a second or two earlier. That was looking pretty good, though. That was giving me hope.
Drivers, start your engines!
We're not dropping frames, are we? Nope. Still, might just be my laptop. Everyone's doing your mama jokes. What did I start? Actually a good method. I'm gonna try to block these cars so that those other ones can get a decent amount ahead. Or I could just do two separate replays, that'd probably be easier. Quite enough cars. Next.
Drivers, start your engines!
I just realized we're right on an hour mark, but this is one where I don't mind going a little over. I don't mind doing this one until I get it. That's what she said. Stop. Alright, so yeah, if I'm gonna do the replay with that shot from the start-finish line showing the cars and then a wreck in the background, I might just do two separate replays. One, because it's hard to explain. So I don't want to be slamming on the brakes the entire time during the replay, but by the time we get around to the front stretch, I want there to be a big gap between the leaders and the wreck. So I might just have to do two replays. But this is, I'm going for the main wreck. The other replay I'm talking about is just that front angle of the leaders coming to the line and just a wreck happening in the background, and then it quickly cuts to the main replay of the famous footage that you just saw. Two flips in that one, and one was pretty big. A lot of cars made it through that one. Yeah, that 19 took a tumble. I guess we had three cars, but the wreck itself wasn't as big as I wanted it to be. Actually, that one wasn't terrible, but we can do better. Once again, obviously, it's not going to look as big as it did in real life. That's what she said, because of the 43 car limit we have in this game versus the 68 that were in that race in real life back in 1960. So it's going to be a smaller scale, so I guess I'm being a little too picky with the size. That's what she said of the wreck. Got the Michael Scott syndrome flowing through me. Bye-bye, pace car. The ghost of the pace car. The 1959 Daytona finish. Why can I not think of that? Was that like the very first photo finish? Where someone was announced a winner, but then someone else was declared the winner after evidence came out that the other person won. Alright, I will let you guys vote in this within this next attempt. That one wasn't that great. I will go for another hour streaming, but I need to take a bathroom break first. That's the only exception. So if you guys don't mind waiting a couple minutes, I will stream until 8 my time for another 55 minutes or so. That being the exception. So if you guys want another hour of streaming, say yes. If so, I will go take a pee after this attempt. And then come back for another hour of attempts. Best video is when I turn left. What about the times where I turn hard right and cause a 30 car pileup? Are you not entertained? Saying yes. So after this attempt, I'll go take a pee and come back for another hour of attempts. So I want to get this one as close as possible. After my goddamn David Ruderman Watkins Glen flipped, all the damn critics are coming out of the woodworks, giving me dislikes because every single detail ain't perfect. Jesus. I think that one car just pulled a Randy LaJoy at Atlanta. Is that the right wreck? Before I need to clarify that reference. Where a car was sliding on his roof, started tumbling, and while he was tumbling, another car came and plowed into him, and then he made him flip the opposite way. That's similar to something I just saw, I believe, with this number 19. Oh wait, no, never mind. Thought he got hit the way LaJoy did. Alright, so if you guys don't mind watching the pause... Actually, no. I'm gonna go to the very start of this replay. And hopefully shortly before the time it's done, I will be right back. Thanks, guys. All right, I have returned. Oh, the replay wasn't even close to being done.
Drivers, start your engines!
All right, so I need to start down low, turn up, and turn down for what? Sorry, that was hacky. Got a Minecraft hipster, Ian White. I played Minecraft during beta before all the 10-year-old idiots came out of the woodwork. I was into Minecraft way before it went mainstream, man. Just giving you shit, man. Just giving you shit. There. Hitting the outside wall. Alright. That one actually didn't look terrible. They're gonna start driving away right away instantly. That's just how this game is. But in terms of the pileup, how did this one look? Looks like a decent amount of cars actually got involved. One rollover. Two rollovers. Not bad. But we can do better.
Drivers, start your engines!
Well, that was about the right spot to do it on the track. So she said.
Alright, I'll stop it then.
So yeah, when you're judging these attempts at how close it was to real life, make two considerations. Obviously, the 43 car limit with this game, it's going to look a little smaller. It's everything, the pack itself and the wreck, is slightly smaller. And the fact that the cars will just start driving away, unless they were severely damaged or upside down, they're going to start jittering and driving away. Pace car that time. I spared him. Right, I got a good feeling about this one. Actually surprisingly small. That's what she said. Alright. To get a little bit more accuracy, I'm probably going to do this in two parts. Two replays. The first part, I'm just going to start in the very front, try to take out as many cars as possible. And then that replay will be the camera shot when it cuts away to that infield shot of all the cars wrecking. Then I'll do another replay. Similar cars, similar setup, except I'll let a few go by, like six or eight, go by, be near the front stretch, and then have a decent-sized wreck going in the background. So I'll have that second replay being the finish line shot. Then it'll cut away to me doing the first replay. Unless I just get an insanely lucky run where just a few cars happen to be up near the finish line while the perfect wreck is happening where I am. I'm probably going to have to splice it. Sorry for getting over-explanatory there. Is that even a word? Explanatory. Yeah, I'm now just realizing, I don't know if I'm more immature than usual today, I'm now just realizing how many "that's what she said" quotes can be taken out of these streams. If you guys haven't yet already, if you could please hit the like button, I'd really, really appreciate it. Doing an extra long stream for you guys today. One, first reason, because that first one got cut short for my stupid DNF that I didn't want to get. And the second one, the second reason, being that I just want to do this one until I get it right. So I'm going to try being in the front this time. Just join. Fireball Roberts did originally drive the 22. Good memory. So I'm going to try a slightly different method this time. I'm going to try turning down. Actually, from what I saw, that one wasn't bad. I'll have to check the replay, but the pileup I saw ensue from this number 89 getting sideways actually didn't look too bad. No rollovers, though, so nope. Anyone else live in the Wisconsin area? Or does anyone else have these stupid local attorney commercials? And their local channels for their local attorneys, their stupid little cheesy commercials with their dumbass catchphrases. Like in Wisconsin, we have some guy named David Gruber. His catchphrase is "one call, that's all." All you have to do is make one call to the lawyer's office, and that's all you have to do. And all your problems will be fixed. One call, that's all. He does all these cheesy commercials with Aaron Rodgers, but it's edited in a way where you can tell they never actually met up in person. It'll just show them sitting in a car, sitting next to each other. But it'll show like one shot of Aaron Rodgers sitting in the driver's seat, one shot of Gruber sitting in the passenger seat. They'll never actually show a shot of them together in the same frame. It's just creative editing. Yes, I know I'm ranting about random stuff. Alright, back to the wrecking. I reckon I should cause a good wreck. No rollovers. Still think that one I saved is probably the best one yet.
Drivers, start your engines!
Alright. So it's not just here we get the local attorney commercials on the local channels. The cheesy commercials.
Stay behind the 719 car on the inside line.
Stay behind the 719. I forgot who. Thing is, like, Hupy and Abraham. There's these weird ass guys that got William Shatner to do their commercials. Which, like, what? He just, like, talks about lawyer stuff and knows absolutely nothing else. It's like, why do you need William Shatner to do that? Can't you find someone else that wasn't in Star Trek that isn't 90 years old to talk about how good your local attorney is? That didn't accidentally drown his wife in a pool, allegedly. See what we can cause here. Let's try a different method of turning an AI car in front of us. That one looked too bad, actually, from what I saw, the AI cars. Actually, no, a lot more got by than I wanted to. Let's see what happened with this wreck. Alright, so a few rollovers. That one wasn't bad, actually. Not quite as many cars. There's maybe 15 or 20, but keep in mind, there's not going to be as many cars involved because I can't use as many cars in the first place. What is a good 15, 20, 25 car pileup? They kind of all bunch together, but there's a few other cars wrecking outside of the main bunch, and like three or four rolled over. I'm gonna save that as attempt number two. Reporting the stream. For what? For causing crashes?
Drivers, start your engines.
Hey, scamp. I'm all for jokes, but you need to calm down on the morbid stuff, or you're gonna get put on timeout. I'm up for a crazy comment here and there, but if you're doing it every single comment that begins, makes me begin to think you may be a psychopath. This might be it.
Don't go over 7. Keep it under 4,500 in a second. Green flag, green flag. Green, green, green.
Hello, pace car.
Whoop.
Psych. Hey, I just realized something. That crash I caused earlier where it kind of looked like that... I believe it was the 2000... early 2000s Pepsi 400. Where there was a wreck coming into the trioval. The 22 cat car tried to avoid it, came flying through the pits, then came out of the pits, almost merged with the traffic at full speed, but just barely clipped a car and caused a big wreck. Someone can tell me what race that is, but I just realized I'm also the number 22, as was that car in that race. Alright, not quite enough flips on that one. Saw 1.5 cars go over. Yes, I saw a half car do a full flip over. Do we have a dammit counter going on? Is that the numbers I see? Are we counting dammits again? Damn it. There, count those.
Whoa, 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 slow down.
2002 Pepsi 400, yes. Thank you. You know where I'm talking about. Where there's some contact coming into the trioval. The 22 tried avoiding it, flew through the pits. I remember Benny Parsons saying... Rest in peace, Benny Parsons. I remember him saying that the 22 might have had a flat that didn't realize it. I don't think the 22 had a flat tire. Green flag, green flag. I think he just barely misjudged how fast he was going in. His ability to merge back in with the pack at that high of a speed, taking that sharp of a turn out of the pits. Bump. Bumping Kyle Larson's dad to the front. Yes, I know that's not Kyle Larson's dad. I know that's Lee Petty. I was just making a joke about the number 42. Only one car rolled that time, it looked like, and it was a big time roll. One car rolled that time, I believe. Yeah. And he rolled big time.
Drivers, start your engines!
Alright, so it's up to 31 now. I need to be like Opie and Anthony and get some hotkeys to have a bunch of sound effects where I can just push a button and a sound effect will happen. I was thinking about something the other day. I was thinking, how come with all the legendary NASCAR drivers they are, Fireball Roberts, B. Petty, Richard Petty, Dale Earnhardt, etc., etc., Jimmy Johnson, as much as you want to say it, the dude does have 7 championships. He's like the Patriots of the damn NASCAR. You hate him because he's so damn good, but you still have to acknowledge he's good. But yeah, I was thinking, with all those legendary cars and drivers and numbers, how come not too many have really been retired like they do in football jerseys? And I thought, with how many new people come in and with only a certain amount of only a limited amount of numbers between 1 and 99 or 0 and 99. Numbers would run out pretty quickly if they did that. So I figured that's probably why. Alright, how did that one look? I don't know if I saw any cars roll over or not. By the way, you guys are lucky. You might have to be more on guard next year. But I was debating doing an April Fool's joke on you guys. I ran out of time. I was going to look up some sort of Rick Crawford, Rick Mast, any guy named Rick, etc., etc., flip reenactment and upload that. Get like 5 seconds into a video and then Rick roll you guys, but I didn't have enough time, and I kind of thought of it last second, so yeah, that's another reason why I didn't have enough time. So you better be more on guard next year for my uploads on April Fool's Day. Alright, did have a flip, but just looked like one. Not one of the best. We can do better. No fatal crash reenactments, by the way, for those of you that don't know. Out of respect for the drivers, their families, friends, etc., loved ones. I don't try to do that. I might put together some sort of tribute at some point for various people, tribute series. But no, I'm not going to directly try to recreate any fatal wrecks. For those of you that don't know, no, it's not insensitive. It is... God damn it, I can never fucking talk properly. It's a little, yeah, disrespectful to do so, but for those of you that didn't know, it wasn't insensitive to ask because you didn't know, so just know for the future, no, I don't do those. But for those of you asking, I may or may not put together. The only reason for may not is just lack of time, but I may put together some sort of tribute for drivers that have passed on. Might put together some sort of tribute like that at some point in the future. If I have time, and if I can think of something creative enough that hasn't already been done. Alright, big one on the backstretch. Big one on the backstretch instead. Ralph Moody. Wonder if that guy has an attitude problem.
Drivers, start your engines!
What mod is this? This is the GN 55 mod. If you Google it, you can find it. And thanks to the awesome artists over at Stun Odd Racing for the 56/55 car set. Johnny Sauter would be a difficult wreck. That one wouldn't be too difficult, but if I was going to be the number two to flip over, I would basically have to be the one to cause it and try to just, I guess, turn right in front of the field. Because obviously I can't plan out or orchestrate on command having a certain AI car wreck another one at a specific spot in the track. Unless I was doing it online, but there's no way I'm coordinating some sort of online reenactment with 30 plus drivers. Not to mention, if it was online with the user physics for everyone, probably at least 5 cars would be flipping during that one. So yeah, I'll do Johnny Sauter's flip slash the 2002 Aaron's 312 big one at some point. But God, I'm just hesitant to do wrecks like that with the kind of feedback I got with that David Rudiman flip reenactment at Watkins Glen. God, some people are so damn picky. Just like I said, if you guys are going to be so damn picky, I guess it's just super easy reenactments from here on out. Which obviously I didn't mean since I'm trying to do this one. Alright. Only one car rolled over and not too many cars got involved in that one. I wish someone donated $3,000. It's not like this is Twitch or anything. I don't get that, by the way. Those people that donate on Twitch, I guess if I was the one that figured out an amazing gaming profile and got a crap load of followers and I had people donating, I wouldn't be the one complaining, but... I mean, who does that? I get people watch videos and support them, and people can get revenue from, like, the ads through Google AdSense and whatnot, like regular YouTubers, but someone just watching someone play a video game on Twitch, oh man, you're entertaining. I like your Twitch videos. Here's money, just for no reason. I have no idea how that works. I have no idea who the type of people are that are donating, but, I mean, people are making a living off it, so who am I to say? Now, I accept donations as well. I only accept donations a minimum of $1 million. Anything under $1 million, I don't accept. Sorry, guys. Appreciate the generosity, but it's not enough. Oh. Is it possible to take anyone seriously about anything on April Fool's Day?
Drivers, start your engines!
Gonna donate $1 million to Codit. Oh, not Cody. Who's Codit? Laying on me for once. None of my cats are bothering me while I'm trying to do a stream. Though I don't mind my cats bothering me if I'm doing one of these. It's the races I get annoyed by when I'm actually trying to focus on not crashing. That's so weird doing these two types of streams. The Can I Recreate Crash series and then the full races. Because one is basically try to do as good in a race as possible without crashing. The other type of video is basically try to crash deliberately as much as possible. Maybe that's why I suck at the races so much, because I do these types of videos too. This is gonna be the one right here. Nope, not even close. Kind of, but not close. I didn't collect enough cars right away. A few too many got through before everyone started getting turned.
Thank you.
Mike O'Neill, I already explained. I know you were watching when I explained. Please don't ask again. Don't want to have to put anyone on timeout. Really don't want to. Yeah, I wonder how many names are in this field right now that were amazing drivers in their time. I just don't know their names because this is 70-ish years ago. Bye, pace car. If you guys haven't yet, if you could please hit the like button if you're enjoying the video so far. Been going officially 100 minutes. We're an hour and 40 minutes-ish in.
The yellow flag is out. You all right?
That one looked decent in my rearview mirror. I'll have to check it out. Looks like we're bent up on the back end. That guy was about to hit me. I'll have to see what these guys all did. See what kind of wreck they caused. Aw. Not quite as many rollovers as I wanted. Got a spectator view. Alright, two flips. Not quite enough. And they're almost a little too bunched up there. How do you step on your own junk? Well, you know, if you get old enough, stuff starts to droop and sag. I don't know, just imagine kind of like stepping, tripping over your own shoelace. But a lot more painful. This one's gonna be about 2. The one earlier was around 1:45. Get ready now. Going green. Pit car's in. Stand by. Need a decent cluster of cars to wreck. Have like 3 or 4 roll over. Not any of them too excessively. Like no million barrel rolls for any of the cars. Don't really have too many other requirements other than that. So I'm probably gonna do some creative editing with this, so just mixing two replays together, I just need a good enough crash for the initial replay, for the main wreck replay. One guy barrel rolled a few too many times. In the memory of reenactment. See, that's a decent idea. Maybe I could do something like the moment they were in the race with this game, try to reenact kind of where the position where cars were, and then right before the wreck starts, like flash to white and then show a picture of them along with their birth and death date. That wouldn't be a bad idea, but no, I'm not going to sit there and try to take this game and use a track and a mod and try to recreate a little detail of a wreck that took someone's life that I'm not going to do. But yes, in a memory of reenactment series wouldn't be the worst idea. So we got about 15 minutes left. Keep it under 45 feeling about this one. Three wide for the lead. That will cause the biggest wreck in NASCAR history. Not even. That was anticlimactic.
Drivers, start your engines!
Ken Schrader, Pocono Flip. That one's been on my to-do list for a while. I've gotten a bunch of requests to do that one. Let's put it this way. Basically, any flip, any major popular wreck that got a decent amount of recognition is on my to-do list to do a live stream for. There's an addition to requests, an addition to ones I've tried before and need to do a part one, two, or part two, three, etc., so on and so forth. I always go to NASCAR All Out. I go to his page and see the giant list of NASCAR flips in chronological order and see what ones might be possible. Look at other major wrecks. I try to look at famous finishes. But surprisingly, the damn carnage addicts you guys are, the big massive crashes / rollovers and flips are always the most requested ones that you guys ask me to do. Pace car. Ghost pace car. Three wide for the lead again. Right, come on, this one has to be good. Tried enough times. I want it to be perfect. Let's see how that one looked. I do give shoutouts, guys. Whoa. That 7 car took a huge hit. I give shoutouts. It's just a lot harder to now that... I mean, don't get me wrong, I'm not complaining at all about having a way bigger audience than when I first started doing videos. It's just a lot harder to keep up with you guys commenting, given that you comment so damn fast. God damn, yeah, see, the person I was gonna shout out that asked for a shout out already scrolled up past my little thing. Past my little thing. When I was gonna say scrolled up out of the chat box, turned into out of my little thing. Do you see why I'm not in television or radio with my speaking ability, or lack thereof, I should say. Alright, so I'll get this out of the way. Nobody, Macro Moose, Derp Gaming, Annabella, Scamp, Husky Tech. Alright, there's only six right there. No! Alright, that doesn't matter. Actually, yeah, it does, because I can't catch up to the rest of the field in time. Burning Fireplace, Pillow Master. There, since you guys are yelling at me for not giving you shoutouts, I'll try to get everyone now. Hold in.
You've been disqualified for reckless driving.
Alright, so here we go. We're gonna get every single car involved right here. Every single car. Entire field. Gonna get involved right here. Coming right out of the turn. Perfect spot to flank him. Think I missed a couple people. Think I missed a couple.
In turn one.
Well, let's see what that looked like. Oh, damn, I didn't miss that one car I thought I did. Oh, literally, like, two made it through. Two or three made it through unscathed. Otherwise, that would have been literally everyone. And technically, that first car that made it through unscathed hit the outside wall. So he technically wasn't unscathed. Alright, you guys want to see some wreck avoidance? How about the 7A car? Let's see if this guy's on board. Alright, wreck avoidance king right here. From like 30th to 3rd. Well, I guess you can't count it as wreck avoidance if you plow right into a overturned car and somehow are still able to continue onwards.
Drivers, start your engines!
Ugh. So I have two saved so far. Like usual, I'll get your guys' opinion of which one out of the saved replays you think is the best. And if I can get you all to agree, I may or may not start editing one of those replays. Or if I can get a better one in the next 8 minutes. Hit the like button if you have enjoyed the video. Really, really appreciate it. Just like Shrek, I would really, 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 really appreciate it. Really? Really, really. Donkey! Who pitched that movie idea? I mean, as much as I love Shrek, let's make an animated movie about an ogre, have Mike Myers be the lead with a Scottish accent, and have Eddie Murphy be a donkey. I mean, as much as I love that movie, who pitched that idea first? That one didn't look too bad either. Daniel Patricia. Burning Fireplace, Pokemon Responder. There. apologize if I missed you before. Yes, I used to give shout-outs more frequently, but that was also when I had, like, two people watching my live streams at once, so I could just afford to be staring at my chat. Eh. Not as close as the other two.
Drivers, start your engines!
Get Shrek'd. It's funny looking back and realizing how many subtle and not so subtle adult jokes were hidden within Shrek. When they come up on Lord Farquaad's giant, massive, huge, towering castle. And Shrek says, looks like he might be compensating for something. Everyone know what that means. I know it's not about his height of his person, but of something else on his body. Bye, pace car. I like this pit road method. Kevin LePage, yeah, I gotta do that one too. I'm so hesitant though to, especially the feedback I got from my David Rudman flip, so hesitant to do big ones and big multi-car wrecks. For reasons I'll explain in a second. That was too far out of the fourth turn. Waited a little bit too long for that one. Yeah, because if I were to do a big one reenactment or a big multi-car wreck, I swear to God, someone's going to be like, Carl Edwards wasn't in that wreck and he was in it in real life. And shit like that. There were actually four clouds in the sky in real life and there's only three in your reenactment. Dislike. There was a bird flying past the camera in real life, and there's not one in your reenactment. Dislike. Richard Petty's fingernails were trimmed in real life, and in the game they're all overgrown. Dislike. Yes, I know that was a stretch. Alright, this is probably going to be the third to last attempt. Big enough, but not too clumped together, but also have four or five cars rolling, and not too far out of turn four, right in the middle of the turn. That one was decent, except it was just that one number 35 that turned over. Alright, second to last attempt.
Drivers, start your engines!
Michael Waltrip Bristol crash. I don't know if this game is quite that level of... This game doesn't have BeamNG drive physics, or crash physics after all, so... That one might be a bit touchy. I'll have to Photoshop just a mangled pile of metal where Michael Waltrip's car would be after he hits the wall in this game. I don't know, Kyle Busch's crash, maybe. I mean, yeah, he was pretty badly hurt in that one, but when I say I'm not going to do a crash where someone was killed or seriously hurt, when I say seriously hurt, I usually mean, like, life-threatening, like, bodily or head trauma. And yeah, as nastily as his legs were snapped, he wasn't exactly in risk of losing his life. So that one, that one's, like, right on the fence for my no deaths, fatalities, or serious injury clause. For the second to last attempt, since I took a little too long, I'm gonna go the wrong way. Come on. Wait for them to catch up. Ketchup and mustard. You've been disqualified for reckless driving. Don't go over 70. Keep it under 4,500 in seconds. It looks like now there's too much debris on the track. Well, that should have caused a decent one.
The pace cars exiting the trioval. The pace cars in turn one.
Alright, let's see what that caused. Couldn't do the Daytona jump as much as I liked. Let's see what kind of wreck I caused in doing so. Alright, 97's toast right off the bat. Unfortunately, I do have to get going soon. This will be my last attempt. I really appreciate you guys sticking around watching this one. This is one of my more fun streams I've had in a while. I really enjoyed this one. I hope you guys did too. I'll make sure I don't spin out so I don't have to go the wrong way for this one. I'll show you guys the two replays I saved. And if you guys can agree on one of them, I might start editing this tonight. This is probably going to be the earliest reenactment I've ever done. Obviously. It's probably going to be the earliest reenactment I will ever do, is what I meant to say. Please hit the like button if you enjoyed the video. Subscribe if you aren't already, if you just happen to stumble upon this video wherever you may be watching this. If you'd like instant notifications for future live streams, if you subscribe right next to the subscribe button after you do, there'll be a little bell button, a little button shaped like a bell. If you hit that, then you'll get notifications for future live streams. I got some social media links down below for you. Interested, for those of you interested, I meant to say. Twitch, Twitter, and Facebook. Alright, come on, let's see if the last time will be the best one for this one. That one, there wasn't that big of a pileup. I just took a huge hit. And look at this hit I take. If you get rid of that one car hitting me to send me over, that kind of looks like Andy Farr's crash. Qualifying ARCA 94. Just the way he overturned and hit the wall. Guys, I'm gonna show you a quick look at the replays that I saved, and I'm gonna get going. Thanks, guys, so much for watching. course, it's going to take forever to load the damn caution. Bobby Labonte save at Daytona in the 71 car. That's funny you say that. I was actually messing around with trying to do that one about a week ago, doing some tests to see if it would be possible. All right, so here's attempt number one. So let me know. I'm going to show you the crash once more. Side by side, so you can get the best idea. All right, so this is what I'm coming closest to trying to reenact.
In trouble, back in the fourth turn.
Just enough cars spinning, getting collected, and piling in. Enough turning over. Hopefully like three or four in the game, but obviously the wreck isn't going to be as this big because of the 43 car limit in the game. So that's what I'm trying to go for. And here is what attempt one looks like. Just the crash itself, nothing else. Just imagine that screeching noise and all the cars turning over. Alright, so that one wasn't bad. That one wasn't bad. Yeah, there was no catch fence in 1960. Dislike. Dude, someone will do that, I swear. You joke about that, but someone will do that. Bye, scamp. Thanks for toning it down on the morbid comments. I'll see you on the next stream. Alright, so this one, a few more cars rolled over. We'll get to go back here a little bit more. So this is attempt number two. This one, they're kind of a little more spaced out and piling in a little more individually. I kind of like that one better, but it's not perfect. I like two better, but it's not perfect. Let me know what you guys think in the chat and comments. Thank you guys so much for watching. Until I see you next time, I hope you have a good rest of your night. See you next time. Peace, guys.